everyone, and welcome back to another anatomy tutorial where we are going to be talking about the anatomy of the canine liver. The liver in the dog is located inside the intrathoracic part of the abdominal cavity, caudal to the diaphragm. This is the diaphragm here, and the liver here is divided into four hepatic lobes. This is the left hepatic lobe. This is the quadrate hepatic lobe. Here we have the right hepatic lobe. And finally, there we have part of the caudate hepatic lobe. The left hepatic lobe is also divided in the dog into the left lateral hepatic lobe. And this one is the left medial hepatic lobe. Here we can see the quadrate, which is not divided here. This is the quadrate hepatic lobe. The right hepatic lobe in carnivores or in the dog is also divided into the right medial hepatic lobe and right lateral hepatic lobe, that one there. The last lobe of the liver is the caudate lobe, which is divided into two processes. This one here is the caudate process, which has like a renal impression where the right kidney is located. The other part of the caudate lobe is located inside the lesser omentum. This is the papillary process of the caudate lobe. So the papillary process and the caudate process both form together the caudate lobe or caudate hepatic lobe of the liver. Let's go one more time and look at the different division of the liver of the dog. As we said before, we have here the left hepatic lobe, which is divided in carnivores into lateral. So this is the lateral, and this one here is the medial part of the left hepatic lobe. Here in the middle we can see the quadrate hepatic lobe, this one here. Here we can see the gallbladder. Right to the gallbladder we have the right hepatic lobe, which is also divided into medial. So this is the right medial hepatic lobe. And there on the right side here we have the right lateral hepatic lobe. Let's look at it. So this is here the right lateral hepatic lobe, right medial, right lateral hepatic lobe. And finally here we can see the caudate hepatic lobe divided into papillary process and caudate process. Papillary located inside the lesser omentum as we described before, and the caudate process located completely on the right side and has a direct connection with the kidney and forms what's called the renal impression. This is here the location of the right kidney, the renal impression. Between the caudate process and the right kidney, there is the hepatorenal ligament. This one here extends between the caudate process and the right kidney, the hepatorenal ligament. This is the hepatorenal ligament. And now let's put everything in the right position as before. And now just for your information and for orientation, please note that the gallbladder is located between the quadrate hepatic lobe and the right medial hepatic lobe. So once you find the gallbladder, remember please, what? The quadrate hepatic lobe and the right medial hepatic lobe. Forget the left hepatic lobe in this case. While between the quadrate hepatic lobe and the left medial hepatic lobe, this one here, there is another structure we can find in the deep there, which is the teres hepatic ligament, or the round ligament of the liver. The round ligament of the liver, called in the fetus before birth, the umbilical vein, it was the umbilical vein, moves normally in the fry rand of the falciform ligament. This is the falciform ligament, which is part of the distal mesentery of the stomach, filled completely with fat, as you can see here in carnivores, and moves on the internal surface of the linea alba to the umbilicus. So once you can see the teres hepatic ligament, please remember that it's located between the quadrate hepatic lobe and the left medial hepatic lobe. The liver is fixed in its position by some ligaments. The first ligament we are going to look at is that one found just between the liver and the diaphragm. At the adhesion area here between the liver and the diaphragm, there you can see the coronary ligament. The coronary ligament of the liver. So if you want to see this, so it's better to remove the liver. After that you can see it. On the left side and from the left lateral hepatic lobe to the diaphragm, there in this angle here we can see the left triangular ligament. This is here the left triangular ligament of the liver, this one here. I hope you can see it here. So the left triangular ligament between the diaphragm and the left lateral hepatic lobe. On the right side here, to see the right triangular ligament of the liver, please find firstly the right lateral hepatic lobe, and between this part of the liver and the diaphragm here we can see the right triangular ligament, this one here, triangular ligament of the liver. Between the right lateral hepatic lobe and the diaphragm, as you can see here. The coronary ligament of the liver and the triangular ligaments of the liver are mainly for fixation, while we can also name some other ligaments like this one here, the teres hepatic ligament, or the round ligament of the liver, is also related to the liver and located between, as we said before, the quadrate hepatic lobe, this one here, and the medial part of the left hepatic lobe, or the left medial hepatic lobe. This is here the round ligament of the liver. Another ligament we can see here is the falciform ligament. The falciform ligament extends between the liver and the umbilicus. Here in this area we can see another two ligaments. The first one extends between the liver and the stomach, which is the hepatogastric ligament. This is the hepatogastric ligament. It's part, of course, of the lesser omentum, extends between the liver to the lesser curvature of the stomach, liver, stomach, hepatogastric ligament. The other one extends between the liver and the duodenum, liver, stomach, liver, duodenum. So both form the lesser omentum, so the hepatogastric ligament and hepatoduodenal ligament. The last ligament we mentioned actually before, that ligament extends between the caudate process and the right kidney. This ligament here, so this ligament, the hepatorenal ligament extends between the caudate process and the right kidney. And now I would like to show you the portal vein, which collects the blood from all single organs inside the abdominal cavity, mainly from the small and large intestine to the liver, yeah, to be filtrated. So here if we move this intestine to the side. There we can see the portal vein. This is the portal vein, and the best way actually to find the portal vein is to hold all small intestine in your hand like this. Just a minute. Just like this, and look at the vein which leaves the small intestine to the liver. That one, it's very clear. This is the portal. So from the small intestine to the liver, this is the portal vein. Here, in the same area, we can see this big vein, which is the caudal vena cava. And here, we need also to talk about the foramen, which located directly between the caudal vena cava and the portal vein, just here in this area, just here between the portal caudal vena cava here and the portal vein here. If you put your finger there, you can go through the epiploic foramen. This is the epiploic foramen. If you put your finger here, you will go directly to the lesser omentum. To the lesser omentum. So this is the lesser omentum where we can find that part of the liver, which is the papillary process. So my finger here is inside the lesser omentum. Firstly, if I move my finger just dorsal to the stomach, I can go with my finger to the greater omentum. So now I am inside the greater omentum. And this is the epiploic foramen is the only entrance or normal entrance or opening to the lesser and greater omentum. So this is the epiploic foramen here. Epiploic foramen to the lesser omentum and to the greater omentum. So the epiploic foramen in some animals are clinically very important because some of the small intestine can accidentally somehow move inside the epiploic foramen, as you can see here, to the lesser omentum. And after that, if this intestine is filled with gas or whatever, or it will be filled with gas, and after that will be difficult to move out of this foramen, and it causes a lot of problem, of course, and in some cases we have to operate the dog in this case.